Good morning all. We have started with center of gravity numericals, right? And yesterday and day before yesterday we took up numerical which was related to T-section. We took a numerical with T-section and we took a numerical with unsymmetrical I-section, right? So you all know what is symmetrical, unsymmetrical, no? When we fold it along any one axis. Say if I'm folding it along y-axis, now this is my y-axis. So this figure is symmetrical about y-axis, right? This figure also is symmetrical about y-axis. That is, when I fold it along y, it will form a mirror image on both the sides. So that is symmetrical about y-axis. If I'm talking about symmetrical about x-axis, so if I take a same dimensioned I-section, top and bottom flanges are of same dimension. Now this, when I fold it along this axis, XX axis, it will form a mirror image, right? This is also symmetrical about YY axis. So this particular I section is symmetrical about X and Y, both the axis, meaning when I fold it along those axis, I will get a mirror image here, right? So we have started with these numericals. We'll go to the next set of numerical. Today we'll take a C-section. Okay, C-section means it looks like C. Now these all are used in industrial structures construction. Steel angles, we say like that. So next numerical, numerical number 3 say. So determine the CG of the figure. The figure goes like this. It's visible, no? So this is given as 75 mm, this is given as 60, okay, this is 12 mm, this is 10 mm, okay, and from here to here is 128 mm, clear? This also thickness we need, this is 10 mm. Is the diagram clear? So these are the dimensions of that. Now how many geometrical figures do I have here in this diagram? Answer me.
Three,
right? So 1, 2, 3. Now when I break this into three components, okay, there are, I mean, in this particular case, there could be two ways. See, I can draw a line over here. I can draw a line over here. That makes it, this is one component. This 10 is inclusive here. Okay. And this entire 60 is one component. So this full one, this full 75 can be taken. This full 60 can be taken. Right. Also, I can make this as one component like this. Right. No. So the time this 128 plus 12 and plus 10 is the total height for this component, and for the above flange and the bottom flange, 60 minus this thickness, 10 should come. So there are two ways. Anyway, you will get the same answer. What I will do is, because this entire thing is 60 given, so let us draw the lines like this only. Here also entire is 75, so let us draw the line here. So now this becomes my first component, second component and third component. Am I clear with what is the concept? Then after that, I have to show this entire figure in the first quadrant, and reference axis has to be drawn. So from here, I will draw the reference x-axis, and this would be my reference y-axis. Okay, so x and y-axis are drawn. So we can see that all the three components are touching the y-axis, and here only the bottom component, that is bottom flange, is touching the x-axis. So this is the initial adjustments or initial markings, dimensions, etc. you have to do and take. Next, let us start with the tabular column. So we'll have components, and then we have area of each component, and then we will have x value, and then we have the y value, right? So first component is this, that is a rectangle. I'll write shortcut. Okay. So rectangle. You all will not write shortcut in the examinations. You will write full spelling, R-E-C-T-A-N-G-L-E, rectangle. So first component is a rectangle. What is the area of this rectangle, please? Can you tell me? A1. What is the area of the rectangle? You tell me in A into B. Don't give me the final answer. What is the area of the first component? Put it into the chat box at least.
Seventy-five into ten.
Simple, no? Area of a rectangle is given by what? Length into breadth. Length into breadth. Right? Now, what is x1 in this rectangle? X1 is a total CG with respect to reference axis. So for this rectangle, the CG is going to be here and it is touching the reference axis. So what is the value of X? Who can tell?
Seventy-five by two.
And if the reference axis was far away, I would have added that distance. Now here, luckily, the reference axis is touching that. So 75 by 2. What about Y1?
10 by
2. Yes, 10 by 2. Why? Because it is touching the reference axis. Okay, 10 by 2. Next, second. Also is a rectangle. This is the second element. Okay. What is the area of the second rectangle? What is the area of this rectangle? This thickness is 10 mm.
128 into.
Yes, come again. 128 into?
10.
10. Correct. 128 into 10. What about X2 in this particular case? Others?
Ten by two
is for this component. And we are doing for this component. Iska CG kya rahega? This is your component. This is 128 by 10. I want, correct. X bar is 10 by 2, right? 10 by 2. I got confused. 10 by 2, correct. What about Y bar? Y2?
128 by 2.
Anything else? 128 by 2 matlab yahan pe aayega. Iska hua. But reference axis is here. I have to add the distance, no? 128 by 2 will be individual CG. 128 by 2 matlab yahan pe hua. But ye distance add karna padega na. How much is that?
128 by 2 plus 10.
Correct. 128 by 2 plus 10. Because with respect to y, x axis, I have to write y. With respect to y axis, I will be writing x. Okay. So this is 128 by 2 plus 10. Right. Third component. We have a third component. That is again a rectangle, right? I'll just admit. What is A3? Yes, what is the value of A3?
16 to 12.
16 to 10. What about X3? Individual X.
I'm telling not 10.
I wrote 10. Yeah. Correct. X3.
Sixty by two.
Correct. And what about Y3? Now Y3 for individual is what? 12 by 2. But where is reference axis? Here. So this distance has to be added. How much is that distance?
16
is 12 by 2 plus 128 plus 10. Correct? So you will write it as 12 by 2 is individual y plus 128 plus 10. 12 by 2 plus 128 plus 10. Right? Once you get this table, you can do your summation A if you want, or you can directly substitute there. Get the x bar value. X bar is a1x1 plus a2x2 plus a3x3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. So we have the values. Let us substitute. 75 into 10 into x1 is 75 by 2 plus a2. 128 into 10, x2 is 5 plus a3 is 60 into 12, x3 is 60 by 2, that is 30. The whole thing divided by the areas, that is 75 into 10 plus 128 into 10 plus 60 into 12. Get me the value of x bar. Calculator plays a very important role here. Get me the value of x, please. Anybody solving? I'll tell you what value I have. 20.409.
5.90.
How much? Come again? 21.9 you're getting?
No, ma'am. 20.9.
20.9. Yes, correct. I have 20.4. It's okay. 0.5 plus or minus to the main answer is always okay, because calculators, that happens. Some of you will take two decimals, some will take three.
20.4.
You go 20.4, yes, great. Okay, substitution is important. Using the calculator is important. Next, y bar. Calculate for y bar. So when we're calculating for y bar, our equation becomes what? Y bar is equal to a1y1 plus a2y2 plus a3y3. The whole thing divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. Right? We have the values over here. A1 is 75 by 10 into y1 is 5 plus a2 is 128 by 10 into y2 is 64 plus 10. 74 plus a3, that is 60 into 12 into y3. 138 plus 6. The whole thing divided by areas. 75 into 10 plus 128 into 10 plus 60 into 12. Get me the value of y bar.
73.5.
Anybody else got the same answer? Just check one of you, till then I'll just explain. So x, you got 20. This is 10. 20 matlab yahan pe somewhere. Okay. This is your x bar. And y, you're getting 73 point. 73 means this total is, this is 128. And this is 10. 138. 73 somewhere here only. Okay. So this is x bar, and here you will have your y bar, right? So that is the CG of the entire figure. Anyone checked y bar? You're getting 73.5?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is about the C section. Now, these are your general cases, that is I, C, and T. We did, I, C, T, we did all three of them. Now we'll go to numericals which have got different geometric figures. Okay, like what? Let us see. Find the CG of the given figure. The figure goes like this. Okay, I'll give you the dimensions. This is 100 mm. This is 60 mm. Okay. This is 60. And here the radius is 50. And they have shaded this figure. Center part is not shaded. Okay. Find the CG of shaded figure is the question. We have to find the CG of this shaded figure. Clear? Let's start. Now, here this R is 50, radius of this. Okay, before going to that, how many components, how many geometric figures are there here?
Four.
Yes. Which four?
Triangle, rectangle, circle, semicircle.
Correct. So we have four, that is triangle, rectangle, circle, and semicircle. Now they have asked, find the CG of the shaded area only. So circle is not shaded. उसको छोड़ के दूसरे एरिया का सीजी वी हैव टू फाइंड ओके शेडेड इज ओनली द रेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ इट अपार्ट फ्रॉम द सर्कल तो क्या करना है आई विल फाइंड द सीजी ऑफ द एंटायर फिगर इंक्लूसिव ऑफ सर्कल उसमें आई विल डिडक्ट दिस सर्कल ऑटोमेटिकली आई विल बी गेटिंग द सीजी ऑफ द शेडेड फिगर सो दैट कंसेप्ट इज देयर सो दीज क्वेश्चन आर देयर वेयर दे आस्क यू टू फाइंड द सीजी ऑफ अ शेडेड फिगर यू विल फाइंड द एंटायर सीजी उसमें ही माइनस यू विल डू द एरिया और सीजी ऑफ दिस सर्कल सो देन यू गेट द CG of the shaded area. Now, here he has mentioned radius is 50. Say I have not given this only in the question. I can still solve this, no? How? Tell me. If I don't give the radius is 50, how will I get to know the radius is 50? How can I find? Any clue?
100 by 2.
Darshan says screen 100 by 2. Darshan says screen is not visible. Is it true? You're not able to see others? Is it blur?
Yes, ma'am.
Abhi? Check out. I will try to write a bit with the darker pen. Okay. So there are four. Okay. I was asking, how do I get to know the radius? This is a semicircle, right? So this is going to be the diameter. So if this is the diameter here, this distance is given to us, that is 100, right? So if diameter is 100, automatically I get to know that the radius is going to be 50, right? So like that also we can find, or they will give you in the question. So we have four geometrical figures, that is a triangle, rectangle, circle and a semicircle. So when I'm doing triangle, rectangle, semicircle are with positive signs. The circle has to be removed, right? So these four, three will go with positives and the circle will go with a negative sign. Now where negative has to be put, I will tell you. You will solve the numerical and you will get to know. So coming back to the numericals, first is the components, right? First component, will I'll start from here. 1, 2, 3. I will take first all shaded, then I will go to the unshaded, right? 4. So first component is a triangle, right? I need the area of the triangle and I need the x and the y, right? So what is the A1 area of this triangle, especially? Half base into height is the area of a triangle. We know the formula. So half, how much is base? How much is base of the triangle? It's visible from the diagram. How much is the base?
120.
Yes. Because this is along this line and this is 60 plus 60, that is 120. So half base, height is 60. Okay, half base into height. What about x1? Okay, before going to diagram, tell me, where do you find the CG of a right angle triangle? Like this, no? So from the right angle, 1/3. From the right angle, 1/3. Here it is 1/3 of height, here it is 1/3 of base. Right? Remaining will be 2/3. Now look into this figure. I'm writing the x1. So for that, I will first put us locate the individual CG. Now, this is the individual CG for this triangle. Now this distance I should locate from reference axis. What happens to x? X is from here to here. That is from here to here. How much is x? x1?
by 2
कैसे आएगा? I've written here, no?
1/3 to 1/3.
Yes. 1/3 of 120. X. This is 120. This is the base. Here is your 90 degree. So from the 90 degree, it is 1/3 of this distance. From when I'm looking from this end, this distance, if I want, this is going to be 1/3 of this distance, that is h. So this is 1/3 of h, this is 1/3 of base, right? So 1/3 of 120. What about y1?
1/3 of 60.
Correct. But reference axis is here. So what I should do?
60 plus 100. 160.
Why 60 plus 100? 1/3 of 60, what you said was right, plus 100. That's it. Okay. 1/3 of 60. So see, CG point is this point. I am asking y bar. So this distance is 1/3 of 60. Correct. 1/3 of 60 plus this distance, that is 100. So 1/3 of 60 plus 100 is y1. Second one, I will take a rectangle. What is the A2 area of this rectangle? What is the area of this rectangle? Here it is 100, here it is 120. So automatically it's 120. Yes. What about x2 for this rectangle? x2. So 120 divided by 2. That makes it 60. What about y2? y2 is 50. Correct. 100 by 2. Right? Next, third one is a semicircle. Okay, so in a semicircle, what is the area? A3. एरिया ऑफ अ सेमी सर्कल कितना? सर्कल का हाफ. व्हाट इज द एरिया ऑफ अ सर्कल गिवन बाय?
पाई आर स्क्वायर बाय टू.
यस, नाउ हियर इट विल बी पाई आर स्क्वायर इज 50 स्क्वायर बाय टू. करेक्ट, पाई आर स्क्वायर इज एरिया ऑफ अ सर्कल बिकॉज इट्स अ सेमी सर्कल. पाई आर स्क्वायर बाय टू. व्हाट अबाउट एक्स थ्री? Now see, your semicircle is like this. First of all, let us understand this. Then we'll go to the reference axis. Semicircle CG I had told is at this point. Now this is your x. How much is x for a semicircle here now in this figure? Forget this. How much is x? How much is the distance? Formula is there, no? Derivation kiya tha. What is that? Something r by डिस्टेंस रेडियस और डी बाई, या डी बाई टू. करेक्ट. सो नाउ व्हेन आई कम टू दिस फिगर, for individual x is 4r by 3 pi, but mera reference axis yahan pe, so this entire distance has to be got added. How much is this? 120. So when I'm writing x, I'll write first 4r by 3 pi, first thing. Okay, 4r by 3 pi, r is 50, plus 4r by 3 pi plus this distance, that is 120 is your x value. Then when we are calculating the y value is going to be d by 2 because it is touching the reference axis. So this is going to be d by 2, that is diameter by 2 or 100 by 2. Clear? Now, is this clear? What is left now? I did 1, 2, 3. Area of a circle. Circle has to be deducted. So what you will do in the table, you will write here deductions. There could be sometimes more than one deduction. So first deduction is a circle. Okay, look at this circle. This is the first deduction. Here I have not mentioned, but the radius of this circle is 20 mm. Okay, so when I'm writing for area, I have to write the area of a circle. That is A4. That is going to be pi r square. That is pi into 20 square. Now, because this is going in deduction, you will put a minus sign only to the area, not to x and y. Remember, CG numericals, when there is a deduction to be done, shaded area numericals, so there will be a deduction to be carried out. So when you're carrying out the deduction, that minus sign goes only in the area, nowhere else. Okay, don't put minus sign to x and y. That is in next chapter. Okay, so A4 we got minus pi r square. What about x4 of a circle? Look at this. x4 is going to be this distance plus this outer, or from here to the center point. How much is that distance?
60 by 2.
Hey, this is 120 pa. 60 by 2 to onta CG il bantu. 16 edu.
120 by 2.
120 by 2. It is exactly the center. Right, so x4 is going to be 120 by 2. What about y4? Look again, this distance, it is this minus the circle divided by 2, or this has to be calculated.
100 by 2.
Y4 is 100 by 2. See properly, I have put negative sign only to the area, not to x and y. Please be very clear. The negative sign of deductions will go only to area, not x and y. Clear? Now we have to substitute for the formula. Okay, you all just start substituting. I have an internal, I have to post a question paper. Okay. Hello, doing? X bar is given by A1 X1 plus A2 X2 plus A3 X3 divided by A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4. Generalized formula only you take. But in our case now, A4 is negative. So when we substitute, automatically this becomes negative and this becomes negative. You don't go to write it here. When you're substituting, because your area you are taking as negative, no? A4. So automatically these two terms will be becoming negative. Do not do fidget anything with the formula. Write the formula as it is. If you write plus and then substitute also chalega. Okay. And one more thing is only area of that shaded when we are doing the deduction, the area will go negative. Rest all will be as they are. Clear? So get me the value of X bar and Y bar. Calculate please. You wanted this? Or you all have written? I'll substitute if you want. I'll give you the X bar, Y bar values. X bar, I'm getting 73.52. Okay. And Y bar value is 63.79. Anybody getting same answers? Few of you can start doing Y bar. Yes, who is solving? Anybody got 73.52? X bar is 73, Y bar is 63.79. Now, I want to tell you one more thing. If some textbooks, if you have noticed, we put a tabular column of components area x and y, and from here only we substituted to x bar and y bar. So some textbooks your notes you will find that they will do another two columns and they write a into x and a into y. What is your a into x? A into x is this and a into y is this. So they'll calculate this a into x here and write over here, a into x right over here. Similarly a into y, they calculate and they write over here. Once this is done, they get a summation of ax, they get a summation of AY, okay? And here we get a summation of A. So as this equation of X bar says what? It is A1 X1 plus A2 X2 divided by A1 plus A2. If I again simplify this, A1 X1 plus A2 X2 means it is nothing but summation of AX divided by A1 plus A2 is summation of A. So what this AX and AY tabular columns have come now? So summation of X you're getting here after adding those. So they'll make use of that directly here and this directly here, they get the value. It is everything same. When we substitute here, we'll have a bigger equation at once we are substituting. So students, children go wrong usually when they are substituting this, the bracket has to be closed, divided by again, this has to be done in a bracket. Sometimes it goes wrong. So you can also, if you feel comfortable, after x and y, put a column of say a into x. So here only multiply these values and write down here in the column. A into y, multiply the values and write in the column. At the end, take summation of ax and summation ay. So when you substitute in the equation, write this main equation. Uske baad write summation ax divided by summation a and get the values. Okay, anybody got these two values? Yes, no, you can put it into the chat box. If you can't answer, 73.51. Yes, correct, Sonali. Y bar, anybody doing? Yes, Pallavi also got X bar. So just try Y bar. Substitution only is there. Calculator may you have to just substitute and get the value. Okay. How many numericals we did? Two numericals, right? Okay, we'll take up one more. Find the CG of the shaded area. Okay, third numerical for the day. Find the CG of the, okay, 63, somebody got, yeah, right. Of the area, shaded area. So the shaded area is like this. This much is given. This is x, this is y. Find the CG of this, say, shaded area. How many components are there? Quickly. How many components?
Two.
Two components. Which are there, Shifa?
Triangle and
quarter circle. Is she right? Anybody else? Is she right or any other value is there?
Yes,
you'll have to say yes or no. Okay. So I have a triangle and I have a quarter circle. Right? Now triangle ka base is given as 80. Height is not given. Quarter circle mein this distance is given as 80. What is this distance, Papa?
Radius.
This is as good as your radius. So if this is 80, this height also is going to be 80 only because that also is the radius. So we have two components. Now when I'm locating the triangle CG, where is the triangle CG? Towards the apex or towards the base? This is the apex, this is the base. 90 degree jahan pe hota, wahan pe base. Right? So now this CG of this triangle alone is going to be somewhere here. Am I right? So this is my x and this is going to be my y. What about the CG of a quarter circle? Where is it going to be? Towards the 90 degree or towards this side?
Towards 90 degree.
Towards 90 degree. This is the 90 degree. So yahan pe rahega CG of individual I have drawn. So based on this now, let us write the values. First component, I take it as a triangle. Right? What is the area of the triangle A1? Half base into height. Half base is 80, height is also 80. So half base into height. Correct. What about x1 distance? x1 is from here to here up to this CG point. Now triangle when we were doing or when we did this type of a triangle CG. Right. What was this distance? H by 3. And what is the remaining distance? 2 by 3 h. Remember I told 2 by 3 h plus 1. That is 1/3 and 2/3 like that. Right? So this is the apex of the triangle. Vahan se it is 2 by 3. Now we have the apex of a triangle over here. So from here to here, because base to CG is 1/3. So from here to here is going to be 2/3 of this distance. That is 80. So x1 is 2/3 of 80. This distance I want. Clear? 2/3 of 80. Now, what about y? How much is y in this particular figure? Look and tell.
1/3 of 80.
Correct. Because it is nearer to the 90 degree, this distance is small. So that is 1/3 of 90. Absolutely right. Okay, so this is the triangle. Second is a quarter circle. What is the area?
1/3 of 80, ma'am.
80, yes. Correct. What is the area of the quarter circle?
1/4 pi r square.
Yes, 1/4 of pi, r is 80 square. Correct? Fine. What about x2? This distance. Individually this, overall is with respect to this. What, how I'll write x2? Abhi, this is your quarter circle. You told me that its CG is lying here. What is this distance we have calculated during the derivations? Ye kitna rehta hai? Open your semicircle, what value you had, the same value it will be. How much is that value? Something r by pi. 4r by 3 pi. By heart, my battery, all of you. Sab by heart karo. 4r by 3 pi. Say, keep saying that. So this distance is 4r by 3 pi. So when I'm writing quarter circle ka x, this distance is 4r by 3 pi. But my reference is here. So how much should I add?
Plus 80.
80.
Yes. 4r by 3 pi plus 80 because reference axis. This is my reference axis. What about y2? Is this, and it is touching the reference axis. Kitna y2 value?
Same.
Same andre eshto?
4r by 3 pi.
4r by 3 pi.
Yes. Do I have to add anything?
No, ma'am.
Do I have to add anything? No, because it is with the reference axis. So done with your table. So substitute. You can try here. You can do AX column, multiply the area into the X and write here. You can do the AY column, multiply the Y and write over here. If you are doing this, then find the summation AX and summation A of Y. Okay. And after this, we can substitute for X bar, Y bar. So I'll write the formulas. X bar is A1 X1 plus A2 X2 divided by A1 plus A2, which is nothing but summation AX divided by summation A. Similarly, Y bar is A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 divided by A1 plus A2, which is nothing but summation of AY divided by summation A. You have to do A into X and write here AX all three and then take a summation of AX. Write A into Y and write all the three and take a summation of A into Y. Give me these two values, please. There are many numericals. We need to solve at least 10 of them, 10 to 12. Anybody got the value? Done, all of you? How much is the value of X bar? Any clue? I'll write what value I have. X bar is 90.37 mm and y bar is 31.119. So my answer. Y bar 31.11. For this calculator is only important knowing to put the brackets and calculating at once. Else you will lose your 10 to 12 marks. Okay. See if this link opens, please. I've put a link in the chat box. See if it opens. If it is opening, please give your attendance there. 39 candidates are there. I hope it's opening. It's opening.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Give your attendance there. If you have any doubts, please feel free to let me know. Any other kind of we are doing still, there are many numericals to be done. This and moment of inertia goes hand in hand. So CG is very important. If you don't understand, please let me know. Biju, Ashwini and all, please put your attendance in that Google form. I'm not going to accept here. Ashwini, Biju, Pallavi, Yash, don't put your attendance here. No, I'm not taking this. Put it into the Google form.